our extracted DNA sample that's been amplified, so we have enough of our sample to do something with. Are we ready to go sequence it now? Is that what we're going to do?
So the process that your DNA undergoes at 23andMe is a little different to sequencing. It's called chip hybridization or genotyping.
And so how does this differ from sequencing? What's the difference between sequencing and sort of what you mentioned is sort of chip hybridization or for genotyping?
So you can think of sequencing as just reading the genome from beginning to end almost. You want to know every single letter and what it is. With genotyping, we actually decide beforehand which parts of the genome or which letters are interesting to us. And then we specifically look at those letters with the knowledge that these are the letters that maybe cause diseases or are associated with some trait that you have.
I see. So you actually have to put a lot of thought into it beforehand to sort of know exactly which positions, which bases, which letters you're interested in. How many letters do you actually, how many bases do you look at in an individual sample?
So we look at about a million on the current 23andMe chip. That means that when you get your results back from us, you can download a million different calls or base pairs from us.
Sequencing sounds like it gives you a lot more information. What are the prohibitive aspects of sequencing? Why doesn't 23andMe do sequencing?
Yeah, sequencing is definitely the future of this field, and we're definitely interested in sequencing when it gets cheap enough, but the main advantage of genotyping is cost. So we know that to get the same results that we get with the 23andMe chip, we would have to charge at least 10 times more with a sequencing product.
Wow.
Probably a lot more.
I see.
Genotyping has other advantages as well. Because you genotype using the process of hybridization, you actually get a lot of different shots on goal, if you like. You get to hybridize different molecules many times, mm-hmm. and you get the sum of all of those, or the average of all of those reads. So you get a lot of information compiled into one data point. With sequencing, you might actually miss the part of the genome you were interested in, and that can be a problem.
I see. So in a way, you kind of have higher confidence, even though you have maybe more limited information in the end, you have a higher confidence about the actual, you know, letter or base result for that position.
Exactly. And some people describe genotyping as almost like single base sequencing, where we're sequencing hundreds of thousands of molecules on each part of the chip. So there's an advantage there that's hard to replicate with sequencing.